So like you can take pictures of your work and then you can send it on Seesaw so your parents can comment and then like so they know what you're doing for the day.
My mom puts comments on. For example, well done, like if I got 10 out of 10 or 15 out of 15 in my spelling test.
I appreciate my parents being able to look back at my work because sometimes I don't remember what I've done in the day and they check back and they say, oh, I like your style of handwriting, for example. And I'll go like, oh yeah, I did that. And then we'll start a chat.
Seesaw is a student online digital platform that allows students and teachers to capture student work and share it with families.
And as a teacher of lots of years of experience, it's sort of a game changer because previously parents had no idea what was happening inside the classroom. It was sort of like opening your walls.
It's like I'm also in the classroom with him and I even give my feedbacks.
It makes a difference to families because they actually know what's happening. There's no hidden information from schools because sometimes schools can be quite mysterious.
You can go on and you can actually draw and record yourself and then you can send it on.
So the way we used Seesaw, for example, in one of our lessons the other day, we'd been looking at angles and thought, well, where are you going to use angles? So we decided on Angry Birds. So they had to create two scenes from Angry Birds. So they had to work out the angles of trajectory to get the birds to knock over the pigs, draw their pictures, upload them to Seesaw, then talk about what they had done.
The angle was 40 degrees.
So as soon as any classroom work is uploaded, there's a notification to the parents.
And you get a sense of where your child's up to and how you can support them and what their achievements are, celebrate their success.
So your parents can like comment on your work and they can help you improve.
Every bit of work that they do, they go, can I put this on Seesaw? Can I put this on Seesaw? My mum will really love this when she sees it. And it's good because it opens that conversation between the child and the parent as well.
I talk to my mum even more about school, even though she's a teacher.
And it brings us, like, it creates this relationship between me and him. Like, for me to have a chat like a mother to a son or mother to a child, it is really very interesting because I see he has, like, he's very eager, you know, like, he takes my interest. I think that's what you say.
It's providing rich conversations and really helping build that deep culture of community.
Well, we were one of the first schools to trial it in Australia, and a few of our classes trialled it, and our parents loved it. So the principal made a decision to bring in the whole school on board, and from there it's just grown like topsy.
It's mobile, you can look it on your phone, your iPad, in the comfort of your own home. At 10 o'clock at night, if you're a busy parent, you haven't had the opportunity to stop.
And the parents are just learning as much as the children.
They bring back their homeworks and things like that, and I go like, oh, I don't do that in your age or in your class, but now when it comes to Seesaw and I look at it, oh wow. So it goes both ways. The child is learning and we are learning as parents.
Our teachers use data to inform their next steps in what they're doing in the classroom. And this has provided another vehicle, another way to capture student learning.
You know those kids who could slip under the radar sometimes? It gives you a good look into them so I can work with them based on what information comes off of the data.
Step It Up is one of our tools that we're utilising with our visible learning strategies around how to show children where they're up to and where to next.
So like you pick a goal and then you set a timeline. So for example, it might be at the end of the year, at the end of the term, or maybe like in January.
Kids are very independent with Seesaw. It has a real student voice because they can actually tell you what they're learning.
So really activating that student agency piece around owning the learning and taking control of where they're up to.
My SMART goal is to learn all of my multiplication by the end of the year. When you aim for something and you get there, it just makes you feel good and it makes you feel proud.
So kids can look at where they've come from and they go, oh, I remember, this is what I used to be able to do, but now I'm able to do this.
If you do something at the beginning of the year and you check back at the end, you can see how you've improved from all your mistakes. It's made me enjoy school more.
I think it's bringing a lot more joy because we're really able to celebrate learning right there and then.
Teachers originally thought it made more work, like taking photos of kids' work or doing all of that. It actually makes less. You spend less time as in physically marking, but you can sit and listen to what they're saying or you can look at what they're doing. Our principal has now rolled it out for our staff. We have to upload our evidence to her on our goals. So she has created a class for herself, and we are her students virtually. So she has evidence of what we're doing. So for her as a principal, she has a very good insight into what's happening in the whole school then.
I certainly do think other schools should adopt CSOAR, and quite honestly, many of them are once they see the capabilities of it. Really just providing that extra jigsaw piece that parents just have not had before.
Every school who's come and seen it has taken it back in some way or another.
When we first started, we had over 500 parents looking at work on a weekly basis, and that has just been on the steady increase. Last week, in fact, we had over 2,000 views of work and 496 comments from parents taking the time to make comments about student work, and I think that is an incredible set of data sets that really show that parents are engaged and are actively participating in student learning through CSOAR.
I've learnt that parents truly want to be partners in their children's education. They don't want the tokenistic, you know, come up and bake 5 cakes and stand on the cake stall.
I think it is of great benefit to my child.
All families want to share the success of their children, and this is a great way for that to happen.